What do you think? What might be the most underrated feature? Yes, it is the feature. I am not talking about the function. So stay tuned for that. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now let's get started. It's mQuery language in Power Query. M is a powerful language which is used behind the Power Query transformation. Only few of the functions are available as menu in user interface. A lot of hidden functions we can use manually, which will be the amazing performance improvement or productivity improvement in our practical real world usage. So M stands for data mashup or data modeling. So M is a functional language and M is a case sensitive language. So why I am going through this is, as we have covered most of the topics in Power BI, but even though I have covered most of the functions in Power Query as well, but there are a few things which I like the most and I want to share it with others. So it's like, with the help of simple query functions in Power Query, we can do a lots of productivity improvement. So we'll walk through the basics of this in this video, and we'll cover the step by step how we can proceed with further in our upcoming videos. The first thing is, we need to understand the basics of it, right? So I'm repeatedly saying in my recent videos that we need to make our basics strong, fundamentals strong, in order to build on top of that. There is a comedy in Tamil that body is strong and basement weak. That should not be the case. It has to be a basement strong as well as the body will get strong. So coming back to here, let is and in. These are the two definitions in Power Query language. So the first thing is the let, and in, both of them are small case as it is case sensitive. And after that, we need to define the variable and we have to pass the variable for that. So let is the definition and source is a variable we are declaring, and tech is the value we are assigning to that variable. Okay. So an in, basically in here is saying it's actually an output, right? And whatever the steps or the variable which you are passing it here, it's going to be the output of it. So let's understand with another example. So I'm using is let x equal to 1 and comma. Comma represent that is end of the line. So the next will be the next line or next step. So y equal to 1 plus 17 and it gives a 18 result. Hash double quote name of the step double quote. This represent, we can give the name of each and every step in Power Query. If you have any space, then we must have to include the hash double quote, and inside to that we can give the name of the step, and equal to y into 1. So it means it will give return of 18 itself, and after the last step we should not have to include the comma here, and in the last is which step we want to return. For an example, in this case, if I'm going to use x here, then it's going to return me 1. As I'm returning the name of the step here, this is the last one, so it's going to return me 18 value. So how you can able to comment? So every syntax, every language gives the option to comment. This is the regular one as well. So double slash will give a comment on single line, and slash star star slash will give the multiple line comment. So these are the literals of Power Query. That is, if you want to use null, you can define the null like this. The logical values are true or false, and the number can be 0, 1, minus 1, 1.5, and these digits. And if you want to convert it to time, then you can define it like this: hash time bracket hour minute and second. And if you want to define a date, then it should be date, year, month, and day. And date time is similarly like this, and date time with zone, and this can be like this. And if you want to type a duration, it can be like this. And a text, if you're passing it, it has to be a double quote hello. the binary should be like this. If I'm passing a list, this is kind of this. And record is like we had to define a variable and assign it a value to it. And we can also return a table inside to the Power Query as well. So this is the step. We need to define the table and column name and pass the values accordingly. So creating a function is like this. We can define with the comma and the rocket symbol, arrow symbol. And if you want to return a type, you can type number and type table, whatever it is. So we're going to cover most of the parts in future videos. But for now, let's go into practical how it actually works so that you can clearly understand what and how it is. So this is my Power BI desktop, and I'm going now to Power Query Editor. As nothing is here, you can just right click here and add new query and add a blank query. So now click on the advanced editor. Once you click on that, a new window will open. So this is the base actually. Whenever you open a new window, it's lit and source the value in and then the source. So if I'm going to pass a value like example this and click on OK and done here, the bottom of the screen, then you can see the result here as a tag. So this is the value and tag. So this is just a basic of it. Now let's move further. So clicking on again on advanced editor, and this is the one. So now I'm going to declare instead of source x equals 1 comma, and then adding a y, new variable equal to x plus 17. And now in source, instead of source, I need to mention y. And after that, let's done. You can see the result is 18 now, right? Because x plus 17 equal to 18. And also on the right side, you can see this step is being shown here, that x and y. Now, just to make you clear, understand, if I go again to advanced editor, here in the in, basically the output statement, instead of y, if I pass x here and then click on done, what you can see the value here is 1. And if you look at the right side, it's just query. There is no x and y here. The reason is, click on advanced editor. This is the first step, and this is basically the query. And we have written this value here as an output. So the Power Query transformation, it will not return this as an output. It will just return up to this step. Now, if you want to add a new step, like here, we need to type it as a hash, double quote, and third step. So equals y plus 2020. And in as an output, I'm going to use hash the third step. So tab and then done. As you can see, the output is 2038. Yes, y is 18 basically, and plus 2020 will give the result of 2038. And if you look at this step here, it gives as x, y, and this step. Now, in order to, as a best practice, you need to add information of each and every step, what this step does. Then you need to go to advanced editor again. And then before to this step, you can add a comment. So double slash. So this is just as an information to the user, and then clicking on done. The value is same, and if you look at the step here, the third step, and then you can see an exclamation mark. If you just mouse over to that, you can see this is y plus 2020. So now the user can easily understand that y plus 2020 in this step will result give you this final output. So this is all about the Power Query basics in Power BI. So in our future videos, we will talk about what are the functionalities in which we can increase our productivity. If you like this video, and if you want me to continue this series of Power Query functions in depth, Just put your post on the comment section below. Also like this video and share this video with others. Thanks for watching. Keep learning and keep sharing. See you in the next video.